Hey everybody, welcome back to the Ox Gallery. My name is Barry, and this is part three for the title Mother in the Art for AI series. In this video, you're going to see that I had gotten to a point where I thought I was done with it, but I didn't like the overall effect. It just wasn't conveying the concept I had in my head, and it just didn't look as good as I thought it would. So I ended up breaking down and just sanding the surface of it and starting back over with a different concept to convey the message I was trying to convey to begin with. So anyway, let's get to it and hope you guys enjoy the video.
Okay, so what I've done here is I've put a little bit of silicone around each circle so that I can pour a little bit of pigment on the back side here. This piece is pretty much probably going to be a non-lit piece, but I was wanting to test out trying to work on some pieces with lighting. And when I first poured this, I poured clear and then I poured a layer of pigment on the surface, thinking that I wanted to let more light through because I wasn't sure how much the pigment was going to keep light from passing through. And it ended up being actually too light. So I probably could have just poured straight color and not worried about pouring the clear the first time. So what I'm going to attempt to do is I'm going to pour some darker blue and some darker gold on the backside so that if it is lit up, then the colors should appear darker, which is the look I'm going for. But if it's not lit up, the colors on the front won't be changed at all. Like, this is just filling in the backside, so if light passes through it, theoretically it should darken the colors since I'm going with darker pigments. But we'll test it out and we'll see. So I just want to give you a heads up of what I'm doing here. Like I said, it's not going to really change the overall look of the piece if it's not lit up, but this is just me playing around with it to work out some kinks and some trial and error on using pigment, epoxy, and then trying to add some light to some of my pieces. So, all right, let's get started. All right, so I'm done filing these down, and this piece is going to be full of little tests, I guess. What I'm going to do with this is I've got some chalkboard paint. I normally coat the back of these in a chalkboard paint, and then I usually sign it with pencil, and then I usually spray a sealer over it. But this piece, I want to test something out. I put the silicone around here to hold these colors in when I was testing out my other idea with trying to get light to come through these areas. And the paint's not going to stick to the silicone well. It'll dry, but it'll eventually crack or peel off. So I'm just going to test something out just to see what happens. I'm going to go ahead and paint this in chalkboard paint, and then so I can sign it and then seal it. But when I seal it, I'm going to actually pour some silicone over top of this to kind of lock everything in place. And I want to see how the epoxy reacts with the paint that will be loosely adhered to that silicone. So it may not do anything, but we'll see what happens. Let's get started. Thank you. All right, well, so I don't know if you can see from this shot very well, but I have been messing with this piece. I was not real happy with the tape lines I had. I don't know, just the, I don't know if it's the width of them or just the way they looked, but it looked like I had just took some clear Christmas wrapping tape or something and just ran lines. And I don't know, it just, the more I looked at it, the more I kept seeing it, the more it kept bothering me. So what I'm going to do is I've been picking at the edges a little bit here, and you can see some of that. But I'm going to start out with some 600 grit sandpaper. I want to wet sand and try to get rid of, or at least try to blend it enough to where I can do a clear pour over it and kind of see, you know, where it goes from there. I think it's salvageable. I don't know. We'll see. But I definitely wasn't happy with the way those lines came out, or where I definitely wasn't going to sell it. So either way, you know, we'll see what happens. We'll make something out of it. But all right, let's get to it. Oh, also, the clear lines originally were to, I wanted all the pieces to be somewhat connected somehow, so that's why I had taped off and did a matte finish over it, and then that way it would have these shiny lines connecting these pieces together. And so what I'm going to do to continue with that concept is I came up with the idea of just doing some bits and bytes. I'm just going to get out my paints and a small brush, and I'm just going to do ones and zeros and fill it in those lines and go that route with it, because I think that actually will even look better and even convey some of the message of the overall piece even better, being that it's a mixture, a little bit of Mother Earth, motherboard, and you know, motherhood. So anyway, let's get to it, and let's make something happen. Thank you.
Thank you.
All right, the clear pour is dry, so I'll give this another day to cure, and then I can move on to the next stage of sanding and getting it prepped for another layer of paint. I'm going to do some more detail painting on this. I got some more bits and bytes I want to put in there on these lines that you see right here. I may do some more highlights around this, the blue center, and then I might do some detail around the gold areas as well. I don't know, I'm going to play around with that a little bit. So I look forward to seeing you guys in the next one. Please be kind to one another, and remember to hit that subscribe and the like button. And if you want to keep up when I post the videos, be sure to hit that bell so you can get notifications. All right. You guys have a great day. Take care.